California Senate Bill 946 is for sidewalk vendors. And basically what it is a bill that went into effect January 1st of 2019, where people in California can be sidewalk vendors without it being criminalized, without them being shut down, fines, or tickets. So you're able to set up a table right now if you have some kind of craft, art, business, service, whatever, an entrepreneurial idea. You can set up a table at parks or beaches, and the local authority cannot regulate you. Now, there's other provisions on it where the city can have their own separate ordinances for safety and health, depending on their discretion of that. So obviously, if they feel that one area starts to get too packed with vendors, or it's blocking walkways, or handicap accessible areas, or whatever they could come up with, then they have the right, cities and counties have the right to put regulations on the Vending Act. But as it stands, anyone can be a vendor in California right now. If you're doing food, you still need the food handlers and the health permit and all that. And I don't know how that would work with it was with weed and stuff like that that's legal in California. I don't know if someone, I haven't seen it out here in La Jolla. I'm just waiting for someone to jump on it, someone to be a vendor out here doing, whether it's they do flower or wax, whatever their thing is in the cannabis industry. But I mean, that's a whole nother thing where I don't know if there's further laws that prevent them from doing that because it's out here in public, or they need extra licensing. I don't know. But depending on what your idea is, or something you want to try, as of January 1st of 2019, you can set up out here without a permit. So I work for this nonprofit in San Diego where we've had site-specific spots for 30 years. This nonprofit has, where we set up around the city. So we've had permits for multiple years prior to this law, but since they passed it and it went to effect January 1st of 19, I've seen a lot more vendors out here in La Jolla and Pacific Beach, different parts of the city, and it's good. I actually did an interview. I'm gonna put a link in this video in the description, where CBS did an article about the vendors, how some locals don't like the increase of vendors. Some of them are for it. And so I was working one day when CBS happened to be here in La Jolla and asked if I wanted to do the interview, and I said yes. So I talked a lot about how, you know, we have big businesses here and it encourages small business and entrepreneurs. And if I could go to a big business, a big store, and buy like a piece of jewelry, why would I go there when I could support a local? You know, so it kind of spreads the pot a little better. How's it going?
Good, how are you
doing? Doing good. I have kid sizes there, adults on this side.
Okay, thank you.
You got it. But it spreads the pot a little bit more for other people that maybe they've always wanted to try a business and they've never had the avenue or the encouragement to do that. And this vendor law can give them peace of mind in knowing that it's not going to be criminalized, where if they set up out here, a cop could come and shut them down or arrest them or ticket or fine or whatever. So it's good to encourage our own city to be business owners, our own city to come up and do their own independent thing. Even like the jewelry I'm wearing right now, this woman sells Naturally Wired Art. That's the name of her business, naturallywiredart.com. And I'll put that in the description too. But she usually sells at Children's Pool at the other end of the cove. And they got this really awesome necklace with like the shark's tooth and the jewelry beaded on there. It's super cool. And so she does a bunch of art like this. And then I'm also wearing one that's like a wave. So it's like a lot of cool wired art. And so it's like these really creative ideas that people can come out here and do. And we can support people in our own city. How you guys doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Doing good. I have the finger puppets and the white seals, medium-sized seals, and then the big ones. The spotted one makes noise.
Oh, serious?
Yeah, there's a button in there.
They're so cool.
But yeah, so even I mentioned on this channel too and other content that I have a vegan diet. So, you know, someone says, oh, you're wearing a shark's tooth. Like, isn't kind of hypocritical, but it's just, for me, it's like supporting businesses out here. Like, I've had a guy in Pacific Beach that wanted to do
a shirt line that would help homeless people, and he was trying to get that off the ground, and I don't know how he's currently doing with that now, but he gave me a shirt once, and I wore it, I repped it, you know. It's like if someone asks, hey, where'd you get that shirt? Oh, this guy's started this business or this cause or whatever. So it's like, you know, I personally go vegan. Someone has a shark tooth, and she gave it to me. I think it's a really cool piece of jewelry, and I'm, you know, encourage her business to grow, you know, regardless of whatever, because we're all hypocritical. Everything's irony. So if my whole philosophy on it is just seeing growth in general, regardless of one or two things that someone could point out, oh, that didn't line up with what you said or did. It's just like, no, I'm trying to think of more collective so that all people can improve. I want to see the vendors do well out here. Why not have a local succeed? So you guys going with that one?
Yes.
All right, the sound ones are 22, 20 plus tax. Yeah, so basically added the sales tax, and we don't deal with coins, so I just round it to the next dollar.
That was cool. We're going to get this one that makes noise. It's not the noise one.
You guys having a good morning?
Yeah, it's just dark. No,
cool. Yeah, it's nice out. It's beautiful.
Grandma has it in her arms. She can buy it for you.
Go watch the real ones, and I'll be right behind you.
Yeah, over here on this end of the cove, these are the sea lions, and then the seals are down at Children's Pool. The two different groups of animals, they don't mix together, but they stay in their separate spots.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, they're both cool to see, though. Those seals are in pupping season right now.
Really?
Yeah, so the beach is closed off, but you can see on the outside, you can see at the beach, all those little ones and everything. So just this one or that one, too?
That one.
Okay, for sure. I wasn't sure. Just catch that kid. He's running away. Thank you.
He's advertising for you.
Yeah, that's one way to look at it. That's cool.
He just learned to walk. He'll go everywhere now.
How old is he?
One.
Okay. Learned recently? Got on his feet?
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
That's a big step.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, guys.
Hey,
enjoy the rest of your day.
Do you have a bag?
I don't have a bag.
I do.
There you go, right in the jacket. Perfect.
Whatever it takes.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, so that's the thing about this vendor law too. Even though I'm with a nonprofit where we've had permits, just the experience of just being out here, you know, like people come up from all over the world. You never know who you're gonna meet, interesting conversations, different religions, different cultures, different races. You learn more about yourself, you learn more about other people, about just life in general. And whether someone buys something or not, that's not the point. Like, obviously you want to make sales, you want to make money, but there's more going on than that. So for me, just like talking about the vendor law in this video, and other content I've had too, where I'll be filming a YouTube video here and I'll have customers come up and interrupt me during my video sometime. But it's cool though. It shows the point of what I'm talking about, where I am here working, I am here selling for this nonprofit, but I'm also doing my own personal stuff with this YouTube channel to try to take that off. And they're both important and it all plays together. But just like the people that came up now with the family with the little kids and everything, they bought a seal toy right now. Like the vendors in general, I like that we can have this where people can come out to, well, I'm in San Diego, so I'm going to use the example of La Jolla and Pacific Beach, certain areas that we can come out and make a little bit of money, where if someone's going to buy a tie-dye shirt or a seal toy, souvenir, whatever the case may be, they could go to a big business and buy from them, or they could buy from me, or buy from both. But the point is, it's like, why not encourage vendors to come out here? You know, like I was saying with this shark tooth that I got from Naturally Wired Art, I've seen Gina set up for a little bit now. She sets up in Children's Pool at the other end of La Jolla Cove. But I've met so many people that are vendors that, you know, trying to take a business off the ground or an idea. And to be able to come up and set up like a plastic table and just put your stuff out there and be able to promote it, sell it, whatever the case may be, it's a great time to be living. I mean, this is a very awesome law, and I hope they don't put more regulations on it. I could see that they might if it gets to a point where it starts looking like a swap meet out here. Like if you have like 500 vendors lined up right here in this part of the cove today, it's just me and no other vendors over here right now. But down there, there's a couple today. So it's not too crazy or anything. You know, right now it's very low key. A lot of people don't even know about the law. I could see them putting regulations on it. Like I said, if you see like 500 people here, it starts getting congested, or people aren't paying taxes, or certain things that could come up with that. But as long as people can police themselves and have some common sense, like if you're doing something similar to someone, like if someone's setting up their own thing, like naturallywiredart.com, and you have jewelry that's similar, common sense would be don't go within 2 feet of her table, right? You go to the other end of the cove or a different park, or at least like a couple spots down. But being conscientious of what's going on so that everybody succeeds. You know, you don't want this to turn into someone thinking, oh, I'm just gonna go make quick money at the beach, and then we have like 500 people out here that really just want to make a quick buck at the beach and don't really understand their product or their service, or other people succeeding, or keeping walkways open, or being respectful out here. Like, nobody owes you a sale. They can come up and look at your stuff and respectfully decline, or even if you do get into some like confrontation with someone, or just handle it maturely. You know, we don't want this turning into something where everybody starts getting regulated. We want everyone to maintain being a vendor, because that's an awesome opportunity. Like, a lot of people have these ideas of what they want to do, and the time period they live in, or the family they have, the circumstance, the city they live in, there's things and forces that prevent them from starting. Like me selling tie-dye right now, I couldn't make that work full-time in, like, Nebraska or, like, Salt Lake City or something. You know, it's just, like, San Diego is, like, perfect for that. The amount of tourism we get for the sales, and just the California, Southern California vibe that goes right with the tie-dye. It's something that I'm able to do here. But maybe someone has that business idea, that opportunity, but they live in Kansas, right? So, but they can't, like... They live with a family that said this is how it is. Maybe they're grow up with a certain religion. Then they go to a school that says, like, no, you do this, and no, you got to go to college because you're gonna fail otherwise. And they have all these other forces telling them about the world, but they might have this business idea. But because they live in Kansas with all those other things I said, there's just not, like, they don't have the avenue to just like set up somewhere in public and like, hey, here's my art, here's my craft, here's my service, here's what I do, here's my business, because like the laws either prevent it, or like other people tell them like, no, this is the path to take, get a real job. So something like this in California with this vendor law, it encourages people to come out and be a business owner in 2021 where they couldn't in 1981, you know, depending on just the way things were. I mean, you could still start a business in 1981, but I mean, the accessibility for people to do it just wasn't there, because I mean, you can have an online business. You could have with the vendor law, come out here and sell your stuff in person and have an online business. That's the thing too. It goes deeper than just starting a business or, you know, like you being more successful. Part of the reason that it's hard for people to make that push, because I get people all the time that ask me about this. They see people set up and they're like, dude, is this a thing? Like, people can just like set up like legally and just sell? I'm like, yeah, dude, like a cop walk by, say good morning or hi or whatever, and you'll be fine. Just take a plastic table, set it up. And people, sometimes when I talk to them, they're really shocked that this is actually a thing. They're like, wow, like I have this book I'm writing. I'd love to see if I can come out and sell it. Or it's like, oh, like I do, you know, my own pottery, or one woman, she did glass wind chimes I've seen, or people that were selling masks last year did really well doing that. A different clothing line than tie-dye and the nonprofit I work for. Just whatever the case may be. So it opens people's minds, like, I can come out here and sell it. But like I said, it goes deeper than just you starting a business. A lot of people, they have a situation, maybe they go home and they wash the dishes by letting them soak for an hour before getting to them. And so they live with a family member or roommate or someone who they do it right away. So because they live with people that make those evaluations on these petty day-to-day things, that affects the person's view of what that person is doing out here in the world. So if like I live with someone and I like let the dishes soak for an hour and then I get back to washing them, if someone's method is, oh, I clean them right away and I live with them, they might have some evaluation on me and have already evaluated my character or intelligence or whatever the case may be. So if I say, hey, I'm going to go be this business owner out here, it's just met with discouragement and people talking it down because it, like, they don't know the Walmart owner, they don't know the Nike owner, right? So I'll just have hundreds of dollars here to have some billionaire just make a bunch of money. But oh, I know you. I remember you when you were 12 and you messed up that one thing. So I don't get why you would be out here in this context. And that's just that's just how people are. So that's another reason for this vendor law that I want to go over, why it's so critical, because it gives people the opportunity to come out here, show their stuff, do what they want to do in front of tourists and an audience of the entire world, San Diego being such a highly populated city and then a huge tourist destination. You could have someone come out here and respect what you do, respect your business, respect your art, your craft, your service. None of that judging you on your past or like, this is how one family member views you or one friend or one person from your high school or your college or someone you worked with, and therefore their evaluation in that time affects like their evaluation of what you're doing here. The vendor law opens people up to actually hit their potential. So California Senate Bill 946, I'll put information, a link in the description, and also Naturally Wired Art, which I'm wearing right now, an example for the video. But I love the vendor law.